How about tomorrow? Or in the shop today. How you guys doing? Today is a catch-up day. I've got some mail. I got a little project I worked on from a viewer who asked me to make up a box, and so we'll show you that. Saw that shirt there, pretty nice. A very generous viewer made up some shirts for me and stickers. How about that? So these will, I'm going to be bringing these to the bash, and there'll be stickers going out in the orders and things like that when you buy a tool. So I have to thank you to my generous viewer who supplied these. He didn't want to be his name mentioned, so that's the way that is. And I have some, like I said, some mail. And I got a couple other things I'll probably show you. See that blue box right there? And there's another one over sitting over here for right now. Those are Harbor Freight, U.S. General, roll-arounds. They are an awesome deal as far as, you know, these are really pretty well made. And you can't turn down the price of them. Actually, very well made. I'm very surprised at how well they made they are. They all come pre-together. All you have to do is put the wheels and the handle on them. So I picked up a couple of them. And probably get a third one even. I have a little rearranging that's going on, or going to go on. And we'll swing around over here. That's the closing lathe under the sheet over there. And my son bought a house, his first house. And he's going to be taking possession of that lathe. So we'll be moving that out, and I'm going to put some toolboxes over there. Storage, right? Use up every inch I can do here. And I decided I'm going to put toolboxes along that wall. Maybe even put a bench on top of them. Viewer, I've showed a couple boxes before, probably this one and stuff in the video. These 3D printed and with a thread, boom, and the, you know, with holes in them for punches and such. Anyway, a viewer asked me about these and asked me if I'd just send them the files. Well, I made these with specific hole sizes and things like that, so it was a little hard to send somebody something without knowing exactly the size of the holes you want and all that. What I did is I sat down and redesigned and used a method within Fusion, their parameters, and made a table of parameters so that you can go in and easily just adjust. You can set all the hole sizes, even a center hole, but if you set it to zero, it will make no hole, right? So, and it's a setup for nine holes, but you can adjust their spacing a bit, and you can adjust, of course, the hole size. So, and with threads, and it will, and you tell it how long the punch is, also. So it'll then adjust the size of the lid, height of the lid, and you can adjust all the hole sizes and then print your own. And Tom was the viewer, and he did it, printed his box, and it came out perfect. I printed one also, and it worked out just beautiful for these. These are Sterrett pin punches, and I used PETG material. The stuff is really nice. I really like this stuff, and I printed fairly thin, but that's okay. It's a plenty good enough for a box, and with a screw lid now. Then I changed it, made another lid so I could put my logo in it, so it's not just a plain lid. And I got a nice logoed lid. Then I adjusted it, so I printed it for some taller punches. These are 7-inch, the max here ones are 7 inches. And so I had some other punches sitting around, so I You can put a hole in the middle and cold chisel in the middle out of my airplane tools and with the logo. So that came out pretty good, and just by adjusting some parameters. And this was an older box I made for these really long punches here. And I might print a new one to match all these. But these all came out. This was printed with PLA, this one. And this one, I think, was printed with PLA also, actually. But you can print it with anything you wanted. Anyway, so this was a good little project, a fun project. So it's adjustable. All I got to do is open the file, change the size of the holes, and boom. It makes the box for you, and you can print yourself a box up. So that was a good project. Tom over at Hilltop Machine Works sent me a sticker, so you should check out his channel. And then, of course, Mr. Tubalcane. I had to pick up one of his shirts. I had to have a shirt. So everybody should be picking up a shirt to help out Lyle and get him to the bash and things like that. Help him out in his shop. So these are pretty bright shirts. So check out Lyle's campaign and get a shirt. This is from Solarfire Technologies. This is from Tim Gack. I know his name, and I've met him. And I met him at Mr. Pete's. And he's up in, I want to say, Michigan. And Tim is a really nice guy. But he wrote a very nice, and he sent me some stickers, little Solar Fire stickers here. Now, Tim has a, I would say, he calls it a garage saw. But he's turned it into, in a few years, Solar Fire. He's turned it into, actually, a profit-making shop. And he wrote a very nice little letter here. And he sent me some of his swag, Solar Fire Technologies. And he, very kind words. But I think that his letter stands out in that I think there could be there's probably a lot of people out there that have wanted to say this sort of thing. And Tim is a very nice guy. And, you know, he just sent some of this stuff. And he doesn't want to have self-promotion or anything. He doesn't even ask to, you know, be shown in the video. But he makes some parts for the electronics industry and circuit board assembly, a CNC machine. He uses Fusion. And he basically says that if it wasn't for Mr. Pete and others in the YouTube community, he wouldn't even be doing what he's doing. But he's actually making money at it. And he's a really nice guy. I have no idea. I've never seen his products or anything, but thank you, Tim, for sending the pens and the stickers. And if people are interested, hopefully they'll check you out at solarfiretech.com. www.solarfiretech.com. I'll put a link in the description. So thank you, Tim, for sending this stuff on to the shop. More mail here. This is actually something I bought. And this is from Greg Porter. He has a channel, Greg's Garage. And he's got like 50,000 or something subscribers. He's got a lot. But, you know, you might want to check him out. Greg makes products and things to work on guitars and musical instruments. And he's got some innovative things, I think, for guitars. But he came up with this idea for this little square. It's kind of like a speed square. It's just really small, and it's anodized aluminum. It has markings, you know, here, quarter inch, half inch, you know. So it's about 2 inches. I have not checked it for accuracy yet, but he has another YouTuber actually make these. And so they're made in the USA. So I thought I'd support Greg and stuff. He's bought a couple of my scribes, and he uses my stuff. So why not have something of his, right? So anyway, you might want to check out Greg's channel. And he moved to Colorado, and he's starting to do stuff in his shop again, in his garage. So check out Greg. I'll put a link down there in the description, of course, to Greg's channel. Nice little square. Did a little tool trade with another viewer for not the micrometer. Micrometer's mine, but a nice little, it's a Minotoyo micrometer stand. He had a couple of them and wanted to do some trading. And yeah, Minotoyo, made in Mexico, but it's Minotoyo. Nice Minotoyo stand, great condition. And so now I have a micrometer stand. Thank you, Bill, for offering up a nice trade. Another viewer, Bill, and he comments often and watches my channel. Sent me some Morris Taper number 3 drill bits. Some are a little on the shorter side, but that's okay. They can be used. But quite a few really good ones here that definitely can be put to use. So thank you, Bill, for sending these on. I'm not sure whether this is intentionally this short, like a core drill thing. Kind of needs a little sharpening, at least on the edges there. But yeah, I've never quite seen one of these. Has anybody else? It may be a core drill type, but there's no hole in it and everything, but kind of interesting. And then I'm not sure what these are. Are these may be countersinks. They're pretty worn. I think all these are the same size. They were all like 7/8, except, well, this one's a little small. These three are 7/8, it says. Yeah, so like a countersink, but Morris Taper. So I've never seen one of those either. But they're just kind of old. And they could use some, I could probably grind that actually on the drill grinder, I think, and sharpen them. Kind of interesting. So thank you, Bill. And we'll, I need to make a rack for Morris Taper number 3 drills now. I'm starting to, a few viewers have sent me some, so I can get a rack going. So again, thank you, Bill, for sending these in.